Hi, you're with Mike Redding from Google Apps for edu.com. Today what I'm going to show you is just one quick update that has just been released about a week or so ago for Google Forms. Okay, so I've just dropped into my Google Drive folder and I'm going to create a new form. Now, I'm loving the attention that Google Forms are getting at the moment and all the updates that are coming out. And if you'd like a more detailed video on how to use Google Forms and how to create self-grading assessments, then I will drop the link to another video that we've made previously, and I'll put that in the description below this video. Now, I'm not going to worry too much about titles or themes, but I want to just show you this one new feature that has been released not that long ago. If we click on Add Item, we now have the option to add images. Now, this is a fantastic addition, and we've all been waiting for this for such a long time. Now, for those of you that have been wanting to drop logos into your forms, one way you might want to do this is by clicking on Image, and then you can upload an image of your school logo. If you're uploading a different image, maybe into a self-grading assessment or something, you can take a snapshot using your web camera, uploading it via the URL. You can import it from your Drive folder, or you can use your Google search functionality here. For this purpose, I'm just going to find a picture of a whale. So I'm going to click on that and then click Submit, and it will drop that image into here for us. Now, if I wanted to use this as a logo, for instance, I could just delete that and you'd see that this would sit right at the top of the page, just underneath the title. You can, if you want to edit this image just here, you can give the image a title, and if you wanted to put some hover text, you could also type the text here, and when you hover over the image, you'd have some text appear next to your cursor. The other thing you can do is just justify where this image sits if it's a smaller image. And you can do that on your page. Now, if you do want to use this with an assessment task or a test, then here's what I would suggest you do. Because images aren't actually questions, what you would do is just give it the title, question one, and then just leave it as that and click done. And then what you would do is you would add another item here, say maybe this one, and then don't put another question. You just type in your question, so is this whatever, and click done. And if I go to the live form, I'll show you what this would look like. So you'd have question one, here's the question, and then they would actually type their answer in there, and then you'd have question two obviously just underneath it. So it's great to be able to insert images. There were some really tricky workarounds, but we don't need to worry about those anymore. That's a fantastic thing. If you left that without a title, that's where you could drop a logo into the top of your form, and then all the questions would be underneath it. And so hopefully you really love that update. If you'd like to see other videos on how we would use Google Forms in the classroom, as well as how we create self-grading assessments, have the students collaborating and so on, then you can head over to a blog post that we wrote, which is googleapps4edu.com/creating self-grading assessments with Google Forms. And you can see the URL just up here, and we'll also drop the URL into the description below this video. If you have any questions, we'd love you to send us an email at hello@googleapps4edu.com, or you can drop a question into the comments section below and we would love to answer that question there. Thanks for watching.